Asia One Magazine. Asia One Magazine is an international media house and the only business and news magazine with Pan-Asia presence. We are the pioneers and now experts of a research-based listing of brands and leaders in Asia and the GCC, the Gulf Cooperation Council. We supplement our listing with magazine and coffee table book further, television broadcast, and national and international business and social summits on the brand and the leader winners. Asia One Magazine has always been creating a platform of excellence wherein the leader from different walks to life join hands together to share their vision, ideas, and inspire others to make the world even more prosperous. Throughout our business and social forum, we have always been fostering creativity, innovation, and collaboration globally. Taking forward the journey, we have launched our weekly web seminar to be organized by Asia One Magazine and with Asia One TV. This is called We Talk 10. We Talk 10 is an interaction platform with discussion happening over many interesting topics on business, economy, marketing, branding, lifestyle, and much more. Simultaneously, this is also an exciting online network platform. The show will go live on Zoom and Facebook. Today, we have here with us an amazing personality that I would like to introduce you, even if many of you for sure already know about him. Mr. Rizwan Sajjan. Sir, good morning.
Good morning, Paula.
We welcome you. We thank you very much to have been making the time to be here with us. To our audience, Rizwan is the founder and chairman of Danube Group. Now, what is Danube Group? For sure, every one of you already know it. Danube Group is one of the established building materials firm in the Middle East. It's directly linked to the journey of its founder and chairman, Mr. Rizwan. But who is Mr. Rizwan? Mr. Rizwan is a man with the middle touch, I might say. He has built his company into the undisputed market leader for building materials in the GCC, and now slowly and steadily, leaving his footprinting towards property development and home improvement. The company has recorded a turnover of $1.3 billion in 2018 and has been growing ever since. Under Sajjan's guidance, over the last 25 years, the company has charted a path that transformed from being just one shop with one employee to global employee strength of over 3,600 people and over 50 locations in 9 different countries worldwide, including the United Arab Emirates, Kuwait, Oman, Bahrain, Qatar, Africa, and India. Wow, sir. Amazing, I might say. But a part of this introduction of you and your company that I believe our public already know very well, I came to know that you are also a cricket lover and a Bollywood lover. Am I right?
Absolutely, yeah. See, anybody who is an Indian or an Asian, I would say, they cannot stay without Bollywood and cricket. It is like already in our blood. So we need to love both this without fail.
But I also know that you don't only love cricket and Bollywood. You have always been very participating in these two fields of your hobby life in a very concrete way. Can you tell us something more?
See, if you love something, you need to follow your passion. And God has given me that identity where I can follow my passion, love my passion. So cricket, my brother loves cricket more than me. So we have a team, Danube team. So we have, we always try to play with different people around the country, outside of the country. So we have a lot of interest in the cricket. And Bollywood is actually my passion more than the cricket, where I'm fortunate enough to own the franchise of Filmfare magazine in the Middle East. Now, you know, when you have the Filmfare franchise Middle East, you are directly connected with all the Bollywood people in some or the other way. It's like having your own movie production. So I'm very happy and blessed that I have this Filmfare magazine with me. And that way, directly connected, following my passion in a way which I would love to. So that's
beautiful. I have to admit that I also love very much Bollywood.
Okay, who is your favorite star?
Next time you organize something, I want to come and see from Bollywood scene.
I will, for sure. Every year we have a Filmfare award function in the Middle East. This year it was supposed to happen in April 11, but because of this COVID, we have to postpone indefinitely. So as soon as the situation becomes normal, I will definitely call you when we host a party over here for the Bollywood.
Please. I love it.
Thank you.
We are going to start. I'm going to start by asking you some questions, because while I went over your profile, few things really came to my mind. And I'm sure also our public will like to know that. So, sir, can you brief us on what are the business segments that Danube Group is into, and how is the business in these sectors actually?
Okay, Danube Group comprised of mainly three business. One is the Danube building material, second is Danube home, and third is the Danube properties. Now, building material company was formed before 25 years ago, which is still our core business. After we, you know, made our leadership in the building material company, we decided that a lot of people are buying the houses in the Middle East, so we should open a home improvement store. And that's how this home improvement store was opened before 7 years ago. Now that has been managed today by my son. Adil Sargent takes care of that business. Then we have a property business. We started, you know, because a lot of people started buying property. So 4 years ago, we opened a property business, which is called the Danube Properties. And touchwood, that property business is also doing very well, because we were able to launch about 12 projects and 13 projects we launched just last week before the COVID. This is managed by my partner, Mr. Atif Rehman. And building material, of course, it's a core baby of mine, but we have very, very important people who are managing this business, from Madhu, Venkat, Subhujit, and Shams, and a lot of other people. They manage this Danube building material and Danube home business.
Thank you very much. But how is the United Arab Emirates and Danube combating with the coronavirus situation? In the sense that while I researched on your profile, I saw that you have 3,600 employees with you.
Mm-hmm.
Now, how Danube is combating against this situation, because 3,600 mouths are quite many.
You see, first of all, let me talk to you about the UAE. UAE, fortunately, has been managing this COVID crisis very well. The best thing about them is they have been continuously testing the people, going to their houses and testing the people. I mean, you'll be surprised to note that within almost 1 month, they have tested 1 million people. They have opened centers in different locations, but where they feel that the crisis is more in that particular area, they are going into that particular area and making sure testing of everybody. And the best part is, after testing 1 million people, they are only able to find about 12,000 people who are infected with the crisis, with this coronavirus in the last 1 month. And much better part is, out of this 12,000 people, only not more than 100 people have died in the last one and a half months. So the mortality rate is also very low. Now, the reason they are able to keep that very low, because the treatments over here in UAE is very, very good. We have good hospitals, good people to take care of it, good good medication properly given, good food given to everybody. So we are very blessed and very happy that we are staying in a country like UAE, where in a situation like this, they are able to take care of us in the best of the way. I mean, that we're very, very fortunate about it.
Absolutely. It sounds so that you are amazing blessed.
Absolutely. I mean, if you, when you compare the crisis which is happening in the world, if you look at the other countries, the all the major developing countries like USA, Italy, Germany and all that, you feel very happy that we are staying in UAE.
Absolutely, absolutely. But again, now I'm going deep into the question, because when I saw 3,600 employees, I was really impressed. They are really a lot of employees.
Right. Now, yeah, okay.
How are you handling with this? How Danogu is handling this?
First of all, I have assured my 3,600 people that not a single person is going to be laid off because of this COVID problem. When I say not a single person is going to be laid off, because I believe that these are the people who have built my company when we were nothing. And from nothing, they have made me today to this level. So when there is a problem coming into our country, I cannot be laying down or thinking of laying them or keeping them in a problem. So this one commitment as an owner I have made to all the 3,600 people, that I'm not going to lay you off. I'm going to pay your salaries no matter what. And this is what was happening. March, we were able to pay. April also, we are releasing our salaries. So we look every month after month, as long as I'm able to sustain, and I think we should be able to sustain, because number one, because we're into building material industry. Luckily, the building material industry is running to a certain extent. Okay, my business has been affected a lot, but it's not come to a standstill like another business like aviation industry or hospitality industry. So we are able to manage a little bit of business with that little bit of savings which we had in the past. I'm able to pay my employees, my rent, which is required, and somehow go through that. I personally believe that, okay, yes, this COVID is going to be a part of our life, but eventually, day by day, we will be able to overcome. Like today, for 2 days, 4 days, I would say, Dubai has opened partial lockdown, so which means we are allowed to come to the office and work. So that every week, every 15 days, I'm sure that people will start going to work and life will come back to normal. Yes, that does not mean the COVID will go out of our life. This will remain, but we will start to learn to live with this COVID and somehow start to generate some revenue for the company. And these are the people who are there with me. And if I have supported them, they will also go all out and ensure that, yes, the boss, we need to do something more for the company. And they will help me out to come out of this crisis as soon as possible.
Rizwan, we don't have a public. I am the only public on live in this moment. So let me take 2 minutes to just clap my hand to you.
Thank you so much.
Because the word you just say, in a very honest way, I'm going to tell you this, they are the one of the visionary. It's beautiful that you could see there the people, your employee, the people that made you.
Thank you.
Very nice. Rizwan, how long will the situation last? That is the question I keep on asking myself.
See, I'll tell you something. I don't think this is going to end so easily. And so, if somebody tells me this COVID is going to get over in May, June, July, August, September, I don't agree to this. This COVID is going to be a part of our life until somebody finds a vaccination. Most important, until somebody finds a vaccination or an immediate cure for it. So this is going to be a part of the life until we find that. And as right now, nobody has an answer when the vaccination will come. Okay, we hear that some Oxford University has planned to come out with an Oxford some vaccine which will be out till September, but there's no confirmation of that. But until that time, I believe what is important for all of us to understand that, see, we cannot be staying at home and sitting at home idle forever. We need to come out and work. And we cannot be saying that, okay, because COVID is that, we will not be working, because how long we can stay at home. Most important is we need to understand that this COVID is going to be a part of our life. But for that, we need to make our immune system strong. What we need to do for that, we need to properly have a healthy food life, avoid smoking, avoid drinking. Smoking is absolutely no, I would say, no smoking, avoid drinking. Start every day, gargle in the morning, do some steaming in the morning, have some vitamin supplements in the morning, do some exercise, do some breathing exercise, build up your immune system as much as possible you can during this particular time of the time, leisure time which you have. And that will help you to fight back, because eventually I feel that practically everyone, if not everyone, at least 50, 60, 70% of the people will be, you know, going through this coronavirus one or the other day, where you will be feeling that you are infected with that. But the best part about this corona is 90% of the people or 95% of the people just get infected and get out without any problem if their immune system is very strong. And that is what we need to build in. It's only the 5% of the people who has some complexity in their life, or some major diabetic or health issues, or old people. They are the people who are actually dying because of this. So coronavirus is, I would say, if you're infected with the coronavirus, is not a death sentence. It is something which is like a normal viral fever, which will come and go. And if your immune system will, if your immune system is strong, this coronavirus cannot do anything. This is my way of thinking, and I have always taken this as a positive. And you will be surprised to know that during the lockdown also, I used to come to the office every day to work, and against everybody's wishes. That does not mean that I will not be infected with corona or nothing will happen to me. But I always believed that how long I'm going to stay at home, how long I'm just going to sit and wait that corona will go, and by that time my whole bank balance will be over. You know, nothing. I'll have nothing to do even if I don't have the corona. So we need to work, we need to keep doing and live with this fear that corona will be there. Take that extra precaution and build your immune system as much as possible. That's my way of it.
So we have, in any case, what you're suggesting us is to have always an healthy way of living. And yes, I believe so as well. I believe that an healthy way of life really helps, and especially a positive mind.
Absolutely, Paula. Positive mind is the most important thing. Majority of the problem we have is because of this WhatsApp, where people pass posting all these different rumors about corona, and this is going to happen, that is going to happen, and that builds up in so much of negative energy between all of us that we don't want to do anything else.
Yeah, we are in the same thought in this moment, sir. I am going to ask you, even if it might be the same question I asked you before, but it's slightly different, because you know the financial loss is big. The current situation has turned up a huge crisis also on human resource level as well. The daily wage worker are the worst hit. You say you are going to take care to your employee. Now I'm going to ask you again, how is your group taking care of the people that work directly with you?
First of all, we make sure that proper sanitization is there in the office, in the showrooms. Everybody is wearing, you know, all the showroom people are wearing the different mask, and the with everybody is doing it, the gloves and all that. But most important, from the before anybody comes to the showroom, the whole showroom is sanitized every day without fail. That is so that, you know, if you will be very happy to know also that as of now, while I'm talking, there are only two people out of the 3,600 people infected with coronavirus. And that is the good record, I would say, in my company, that in spite of all this problem, there are hardly any corona has come to us, because we've been very careful. Not today, from the day it was announced that this is there. Now, taking care of the people, every day I need to talk to most of the branches. I give them the positive, like I've been talking to here, give them the positive side of it. Make sure, you know, they also have that same positive feeling like I have. They're out in the market, they're trying to get whatever business is possible. This is the basic thing I think every company should follow, is make sure that your place is completely sanitized. Your people have been, we have created 40 champions across the showroom, where even the down to the workers, they are training, because what happens, the educated people like you and me, we understand what's happening around the world, but not all the workers who are working for me, they don't have so much of access what is happening around the world.
Absolutely.
So we have this seminar or lectures to them every now and then, teaching them what to do, how to do the precaution, what to do the gargling every day, and you know, whatever I've told you in the just before 5 minutes ago. So all these messages keeps on going to all these people, and that's the reason they are able to, we are able to still stay healthy and safe. And I believe everybody, all the companies should follow this decision, and we should be able to come out of this as soon as possible.
So keep on training people.
keep on training people and making sure your showrooms and everything are more sanitized. We are getting some infrared machine also, like just now when I entered the office, we have an infrared machine where we are passing a tunnel where we are completely, disinfect the whole body. And, they have a temperature control before we enter the office. So they just installed today only. So I was very happy that HR department took that initiative and they have done it. And we're going to do this across all our showrooms.
Perfect. So after we finish this interview, sir, I want your words. You are going to send me a picture while you get full inside.
I will do that. I'll send you a picture on how the whole thing works also.
Perfect. Sir, what is the impact of this pandemic on real estate sector? That is, I suppose, quite important.
We were lucky enough as a Danube Properties, we were lucky enough that we launched our project this year just before this pandemic. That means in the first week of March, we launched our project, which was called Olives. And it was at a very good price of 290,000 dirhams for a studio apartment. When I say 290,000 dirhams, in rupees, if I have to calculate, it's not even 60 lakhs rupees for a studio apartment. 60 lakhs of rupees, you can't dream of having a house in even in majority of the cities in India. So having a house in Dubai for 60 lakhs of rupees was a very amazing offer. And not only the offer was very good, we had a very special payment plan of 1% per month, where you have to pay a small down payment of 10%, pay the 4% registration charge, and then you start paying 1% per month. So with this price of 60 lakhs rupees, you could buy an apartment in Dubai, and you'll be happy to note that 75% of the project was sold out within 10 days of the project we launched. After that, this pandemic crisis came out. So of course, the sales went down a little bit slow, but I'm sure, yes, there will be an impact of the in the real estate sector also, because a lot of people are going to lose jobs because of this. But if you have a good property at a good price, and if you are able to deliver a property which is very good, like if anybody knows, people who have seen our properties who are staying in Dubai, at 60 lakhs of rupees, it's not only one studio apartment, it has apartment with all the amenities built in. So when you buy a property from Danube, you really get, in this platform, I'm not supposed to do my selling, but since we're talking about the marketing, I'm just telling you that 60 lakhs, you don't just get a box, you get with all the amenities like a swimming pool, like a gymnasium, like a jogging track, a party hall, spa, like a paddle tennis court, a movie theater, and plus many, many other things, amenities we offer in that 60 lakhs apartment.
Sir, you are convincing me to invest in.
Not only convincing you, but that's a fact of life. Now, what happened is, when you ask me this question, how is it going to be impact? Yes, people who do not offer a value to the customer, that business is going to be impacted. But I believe that if you are able to come out with a value and offer to the customer a good product with a good value and a good payment term, you will still be able to survive, because people will still want to buy. You know, in a place like Dubai, majority of us, we stay in a rented apartment. I would say 85 to 90%, we don't own, we always stay in a rented apartment. But when you have an apartment like this for 60 lakhs or less than 300,000 dirhams an apartment, you would say, why would I want to stay in a rented apartment? I would rather buy my own apartment and stop paying my rent. So this sort of a business of my business model, even after the pandemic, will continue. Yes, if you're talking about the global scenario of the real estate market, there will be effect, because the people who have bought the properties at the higher prices, the prices will definitely come down, and you will see a lot of distress sale because a lot of people are losing the jobs. There will be a lot of uncertainty in the market. But this will continue for 6-7 months, 8-9 months. It's not going to be forever. I'm sure there will be a vaccination found. And as soon as the vaccination is found, things will start going gradually to normal. And at that particular time, real estate market also will be much stable like it was before. And not to forget that we have an Expo 2020, which was supposed to be announced this year, but it's coming this year, but now coming next year. So when we start again, then when the next year comes in and people start talking about the Expo 2020 and pandemic go, the Dubai real estate will definitely bounce back as fast as possible. And also, I want to remind you that even in 2008 and 2009, when we had the Lehman Brothers crisis and the whole world went to the crisis, UAE was the first, or I would say the Middle East were the first one to come out of this crisis. And I'm sure that this time also, UAE will emerge out much faster than the other countries. And one of the main reasons, I feel, because people now have a lot of you know, confidence in UAE, because the way UAE has handled the pandemic today, everybody feels that I would rather stay in a country which is more secured, more safe, where in case of any problem, like, you know, every time the all the ruler family gives an announcement, there are no expats in the country. They are all like my family, whether they are local or they are their nationality or any Indians or Pakistanis or any European, they are all like family and everybody will be treated like same. Now, this sort of a confidence when the ruler of the country gives you, it gives you a lot of confidence. And I personally believe because of this pandemic, lot of people after the pandemic will come and start investing in Dubai because they feel this is the safest country to live in and to stay with.
Sir, talking to you is talking to a visionary.
Thank you.
And you are making really believe even to invest very soon.
No, I don't say invest in my property, but invest in UAE because UAE is the safest place. UAE is the safest place.
And also, but what about, for example, how much loss are we expecting for the Indian real estate sector because of the pandemic?
Indian real estate also, the Indian government is also taking enough precautions. I wouldn't say that, yes, but India is a large country. We have to understand that what we can handle in UAE and what we can have to handle in UAE is a completely different scenario. Like, the UAE is a one part of a small city like a Bombay. So, but you know, if you are talking about India, it's a huge country at your place. So, it will all depend on how much comeback we can do about this crisis, whether we are able to handle this, because I still feel that we are in the first stage of the coronavirus in India. And okay, yes, we are in the lockdown, but okay, May 2nd, May 3rd, when the lockdown opens out, or maybe partially opens out in few cities, what I can understand. We have to see what is the impact. And if we are able to control that, which I have my doubts, because it's not going to be easy to control such a big country. But if we are able to contain in some way, yes, there won't be much of an effect. But if we are not able to contain, then it's going to be a disaster. Especially in the rural, because all uneducated people, you have seen people coming out on the roads and not understanding how difficult this corona is. So I am not able to answer this question. It all depends on how government is able to come back and how strongly they fight it back. And that is going to be the key to the answer of what you're asking.
Yeah. So do you think the real estate segment will bounce back after the crisis? I understood that the Dubai...
Yes, in Dubai, surely it will bounce back, and bounce back strongly, because I always believe that Dubai has made his mark by telling people, look how we are treating the people when all the development countries are going through such a big problem. We are able to contain it. We are able to manage our people. And people who have money, you know, they would not mind. I mean, if you look at India today, there's so much of communal problem over there. Now, all these people, when they are going through this communal problem, they would say, let me find a house in UAE or Dubai where I feel that, okay, I could have one base over there. And the other people who will start investing in Dubai. And Dubai, we don't require many people to come in. The total population we are talking is 4 to 5 million in Dubai. So even if you are talking about 20% more, which is only 1 million people, 10 lakhs people, it's very easy to find from all over the world. And 10 lakhs people more come in UAE, that the real estate market is booming again in Dubai.
Yeah, let's talk a little bit about the future on this prospecting. What structural change, because of course after a pandemic like this there will be some changes for sure, you know, but what structural change are you expecting the sector will go through in the future when things start moving back to normal?
See, if you ask me, I am looking at my business rather than looking at the whole economy of how the oil price is going to happen or what is going to happen to the real estate, the complete economy of the whole world and all that. As a company, I have always believed, and I always tell everybody also, that you should work within the parameters or within the regime which you need to work. Like you're working in Asia 1 and your boss is working in Asia 1. They need to see how the Asia 1, you can try to make sure that, you know, we try to do the best in the Asia 1. The same way in the Danube properties or Danube real estate or my other building material company. Within the amenities or within the resources which I have, with the problem which are going to come in, I need to ensure that I come out of the best of it. So strategic changes, I'm not going to do major of the changes. Only thing, I need to work a little bit more hard to ensure that, yes, I need to do the more out of what I have to do. And this is what we have been training all our people also. Look, you have been working hard earlier also, but that hard is not enough. And now you need to, instead of 100%, you need to 125%. We need to look different ideas out of the box to figure out how to come out and do that extra sale. Because I know that 100% sale, what we are doing before the COVID, will not be easily possible till the next 3, 4, 5, 6 months. So that structural change, I'm not planning anything. Is only thing I'm right now planning is how to get maximum of whatever resources which we have. And like I said, luckily we are into a business where my business has not come to a 100% standstill. So we still have a hope or a little bit of silver lining. Yes, if we all work hard, we will reach not to the budget, but at least very close to the budget. So we can, if we are able to come out of this as well.
This can apply for sure on your private company, but what do you think the Indian government, for example? I'm talking about the Indian government because, as you say before, Indian situation is more delicate, and for this reason I pick the Indian government. What it can do to make to support the business?
I personally, let's talk about Indian government two sector. One is the poor people. I mean, what I understand, the daily wage people. The daily wage people are the people who are surviving on every day. They're working and getting. Now, they are in a huge numbers. You have seen in the past in the TVs, like how many people came out on the roads and all that. Now, they are into a very bad shape, what I understand. Okay, yes, people are donating and all that. So Indian government should really reach out to them, ensure that they do not stay without food, because if they start staying without food, then you'll have a lot of other consequences because of that. They'll get in robbery and other business which is not required in this type of the world. Now, this is very, very important for the Indian government to reach out in every state that not a single person is starving because they don't have a job. Now, that is why, and regarding the business SMEs, I feel India today is in a very strong position. If we get a proper stimulus from the government, today India can become big industry like China is, because, you know, with all the problems which has happened, India has a strength, India has all the resources, India has all the technology. So if we get a proper stimulus from the government, India can become a next country which can offer to all the world what China is offering today. So I personally feel that this can be an opportunity rather than a weakness for the Indian government and the Indian people.
And we already saw that India took a lot of opportunity that look bad to actually rise up and rise up and rise up.
So absolutely. I mean, with the government which we have, they have the vision. They know exactly what they are doing. And I'm sure, you know, I salute Mr. Modi for what he's been doing. And he will definitely come out with whatever best is possible so that India comes out of it as fast as possible. But I still feel my very bad for the people who are poor, you know, because they need to reach out as fast as possible.
Absolutely. At the beginning, after spending so many years in India, I used to live in India before.
Yeah. And most important thing, I forgot one more time, to stop the communal problems over there. You know, I've been lately watching that a lot of communal problems over there. So some government has to put a stop to this communal problem, because this is not the time to start about communal problem. This is the time we need to put all united together so we fight it out. So we should not allow, like you asked me what the government should do. Yes, the government should go all out that in case of anybody is fighting or creating this communal problem, they should go all out and stop it rather than allowing that communal problem.
Absolutely. Now, almost all over the world, everyone started to work from home. Do you think working from home is actually effective?
Yes and no, I would say, because the people, there are a few people who really want to work, for them it is effective. For people who don't want to work, they take it very easy. In my company also, I have seen, like when I come to the office, I call, I'm on Zoom TV trying to speak to everybody. and I see a different reaction. Somebody has not taken a shower and has come and sat in front of me on the TV. So that's one part of one person is already groomed, well groomed, and sitting. Yes, he's going to be talking to the boss. So it is effective. It has definitely taught us. Technology is the term today, and you can work from home also. But I still feel that working from office definitely makes a much bigger impact rather than working at home. I don't think you can have that 100% efficiency working from home.
So again, you think even if working from home, we should keep a positive mind and a discipline daily routine.
So absolutely, you need to know your responsibility. You need to know what's your job to be done, especially for the people who are in the accounts and logistics and the other areas that they need. If they're working from home, they need to ensure that whatever the job is given to them, they are able to complete it without any problem. And they, because of the spare time they have, they should be able to overcome the backlog or come out with some new strategies or do some different thing for the company, so that if that is done, then you benefit. Because right now, you probably, the workload is less, so everybody don't have that sort of a work which you used to have before. So if you have that spare time, rather than spending that time as a leisure, if you are able to work out with some new ideas, new strategies, and come up to the management and show them, look, so we were doing this, but let's do this and try and work on this different software which can help us the efficiency when everything comes back to normal. And now that's what is required from every individual who's working from home. So the workload definitely has come down for all of us.
I agree. Forgive me, I want to ask one last question to you before starting to see the question that our public already wrote to us, and I believe they are many. I'm just going to ask you a tiny thing for all the business owners that are following us in this moment. I believe they would like to know your idea about branding and marketing during these days. Do you think advertising in today's time is a smart choice for a brand in your category?
See, again, we are doing branding and marketing, but yes, the budgets have come down. Danube Home, if you ask me, we are coming out with a sale in Ramadan, and definitely we will be doing some marketing for Danube Home when the sale comes out. Danube Properties also, as soon as the market opens out a little bit more, we have some more apartments to sell. So I told you we sold 75% to 25% apartment still. So we'll be definitely spending on some marketing on that also. Marketing will be there, but it will not be that much as it was before, because we don't have that sort of a revenue which we were earning before. So obviously the marketing budgets will come down, but it's not going to be at a standstill. So we will be spending, the publication will have to come out with a different ideas of how we can get more out of our little money which we have. So we try and spend to that particular publication or that particular agency, because marketing, without marketing, we can't do, you know. And I always believe, as our company has grown with the help of the marketing today, whatever Danube is, everybody knows that Danube spends a lot of money in marketing and advertising. So we are not going to stop, but the budget will definitely come down a bit.
Well, sir, there is one. I thank you very much from my side, my personal point of view, because it has been an honor to handle this live interview with you. I didn't thought to find in front of me such a human visionary, human in the sense of feeling your humanity as well when you're talking. So I thank you for that.
Thank you, Paula. Even I enjoy talking to you, because your accent really makes me happy, you know. And the smile which
everyone says that. What can I do? I try to remove my Italian root, but they always come out.
It's nice, very nice. Really nice talking to you. You're a wonderful person. Thank you
very much from my side, first of all, and then from Asia One Magazine and Asia One Family, but I'm sure it's more than an honor to have you here, and would like to thank you from the deep of its heart.
Thank you.
Now, sir, I'm going, if you allowed me, to steal a few minutes from you, because I see we have a few questions from our public. Let me read it out for you. An anonymous attendee write to us, Rizwan G. You have been instrumental in the nation development process of Dubai, since you are part of the core sector of building material and properties, which has been at the core of the United Arab Emirates development. I ask you, why did you choose to bring forward more affordable properties rather than luxury properties, which are seen more around Dubai and the United Arab Emirates?
Very nice question. We came into the property business 4 years ago, and we were thinking, how should we come out with something niche? Like if you look at my other business also, whether it is building material or denim home, it's something we have always worked out a USP where not everybody is doing the same thing. In the property also, I wanted to come out with something different compared to what everybody was doing. Like this person has rightly pointed out that everybody was offering luxury products in the market. And at that particular time, we came out with something called affordable luxury. And that also an affordable luxury with a special plan of 1% per month. When I started this, everybody was thinking that this man has gone mad. How will he survive when he was selling that such a low property, so low price property, and offering this 1% payment plan? But I knew that this demand is not going to stop, because like I mentioned to you earlier, that 80 to 90% of the expats population of Dubai or UAE still stays in the rented apartment. And these are the people who will want to buy the apartment. And for them, I have to just make sure that I give them a proper pricing and a proper payment plan, and they will rush to buy the property. And exactly that's what happened. When I launched this project of affordable housing with these prices, which I told you earlier, of 60 lakhs for a studio apartment, people really rushed to buy my property. And out of the 13 projects which we have launched, I'm so happy to tell you that 95% of the projects have been sold completely. I mean, I would hardly have any, very few in every property. There will be only 5 apartments or 10 apartments, some bigger apartments which are not sold. But otherwise, majority of the stock has been sold. And that is because two reasons. Because one is the confidence they had in the Danube name, because I'm here for the last 25 years. And second advantage which I was able to offer of the price, because we are into a construction material business, a building material business. So compared to the other developer, we have an edge over them, because all the building material which goes into the making of a building is already there in my warehouse. So I'm already 20-25% cheaper than them when it is concerning the raw materials, which I'm able to pass it on to my consumer who are buying the property from me. And we came out with this luxury affordable housing. It came on hit. And so that's what the idea was, answering to your question. Because I wanted to do the US, something different, we came out with this affordable thing. And touch wood, it has worked very well. And I'm sure in this COVID or after the COVID also, this affordable is going to sell, not the luxury.
Absolutely. And I believe also, this is my personal view of you in this moment. You also choose this road to embrace normal people, not only a part of society that is the top, but everyone.
Yeah. And same in the Danube home also. If you go to any of my Danube home stores, you will find the price are so reasonable, the quality is very, very good. And that is one of the reasons that Danube home also, every year it has been growing by 30-40%, you know. So it's a very, very commendable. Our formula has been very simple. Work on a small margin, offer customer the best which is available in the market, and the customer will come back to you on his own. You need to not do anything much on that.
I pass to the second question, sir. I would like to know whether the infrastructure projects which were just launched will be left aloof or will be completed as soon as possible.
Like I mentioned, luckily in Dubai, the construction sector has not been stopped. So right now while I'm talking, all my projects are running on as before. Okay, maybe a little slow down because of Ramadan now, but construction is happening in that particular area. So it will be all delivered in time, maybe a little bit delayed because of this little bit of problems which we have of the COVID, of the restriction of the timings and the working timings and all that. We cannot work in the night and all that. Earlier we were able to work in the night, but otherwise there will be not much of a delay. Every project of mine will be delivered in more or less the time which we have done.
How have you been able to influence a better relationship between these two countries, India and United Arab Emirates?
We have a small business in India today, which we have a Danube Home Store opened in Hyderabad, which is already there. Plus, my property offices are there across Mumbai, Delhi, Cochin. So, you know, the most of the people who are there in India and they are connected to Dubai in some or the other way, they would know Danube name in some way. So that brand equity is already there for us. So whenever we open any property office or when I opened the Hyderabad store, we were able to capitalize on that brand equity and that relationship. We could go ahead and somehow attach that together so we get the maximum out of it. Today also, like we are talking, in April we sold about 22 units, and every you'll be surprised to know that majority of the in April also the business came from the India market to buy this property, because people knew that the 60 lakhs apartment which I have will be sold if they don't buy in time.
And you are an Indian successful businessman, yes, leader, but Indian. What will you suggest to the other Indian leaders?
Suggest in what way?
How can they embrace the United Arab Emirates?
I think I told you before, UAE is a best country to live in. Anybody who is thinking of migrating or having a small base should not even think twice, because I always believe, okay, you are doing your business in India, you're doing very well, or whatever work you're doing very well. But if you have that spare money, try and invest in a small way in UAE, because the time will come when you would feel that, yes, this small investment which you have done has gone up very high. Why I'm telling so now? Because today, if you compare the prices of property, it's very low. If you compare to all the international markets, if you compare to London, if you compare to Singapore, if you compare to Mumbai, I would say, or Delhi to that extent, or any other major cities in the India, or USA, or any other developed countries, Hong Kong and Singapore, we are at 1/3 or 1/4 of the price compared to the world which is happening. Now, Dubai is a very developed country and developing very fast, more and more developing very fast. It's a very small country to live. The rules and regulations are very good. The petrol price is very less. There is no taxation over here. There is a security of living in this country. So I personally believe that if you are planning, you should make a base now, because today, or maybe after this COVID, after a couple of months, prices will remain at the bottom and you should come and invest over here, because this opportunity will not get it. Because I have some Bollywood friends of mine, and last week only I got a couple of them. He said, Rizwan, find me some good deal because I want to invest in this properties.
Sir, I'm going to steal you a lot off of your time because the question increases and more I read, more Verara. So forgive me, but Verara, few questions that are still very interesting. As you have your office in India, how channel partners can plan aggressively? How important are channel partners for Danube Group?
Channel partners is very, very important. Today, whatever business we get from India is majority from the channel partners. And this is the right time for the channel partners to actually sell aggressively the Dubai properties, because of the communal problem. You know, you'll have a lot of investors who would want to probably have a base outside India. Now, they are the people they need to target and make sure that, okay, yes, you make a base over there. And also, there are a lot of businessmen, you know, who wants to feel that, yes, let me have a base, because like I said, the property prices are at the lowest in Dubai today. And today, like I always tell everybody, that my father, if he had invested in a property in India, in Mumbai, 20 years ago, that property would have multiplied by 4 to 5 times. In the same way, I feel that Dubai, because it is at the lowest price, it is going to multiply 3 to 4 times, because this COVID problem is not going to stay. And when the Expo 2020 coming in, where there are about 25 million people expected to come to Dubai, automatically the chain or the reaction for Dubai is going to be completely different. And that particular time, I would say you will miss the boat. So it is important for the channel partner. This is the right time when people don't want to buy so much properties in India, and with a property of 60 lakhs for a studio apartment or 80 lakhs or 85, 90 lakhs for a one bedroom apartment, start moving, start convincing your customer, because we also offer you the more or less the same commission to all the channel partners and convince them. And then you don't have to worry about the brand equity of Danube at all. You know, everybody knows who knows Danube. They know that they will, when they buy from Danube, Danube is going to deliver, because they are into building material companies. So all the building material is there with them.
We talk about the future. I believe this question really fits inside our talk. Are you looking for any new innovative concept to introduce to your real estate division after this period?
I forgot to mention, we have already introduced one concept, innovative concept in our company, in the real estate, which means if you buy a one bedroom, you can use it as a two bedroom. Now, when you say how you can use it, your one bedroom as a two bedroom, what happens is the one bedroom or the bedroom which you have, you stays as a bedroom. The living room which is there converts into a bedroom in the night time. If you go to the, any of the Danube Properties website, you'll get to know that how the living room, which is a sofa, converts into a bed in the night time, and which is a completely, you can close the bedroom and become the two bedroom in the night. So we have this innovative concept, which a lot of people have liked it, and we are using it for all our properties. So this is, we always advertise also, pay for one bedroom, but use it as two bedroom.
That's nice. Very interesting. I am going to, as soon as we finish this interview, I'm very curious.
I will send you the video for that also.
Please. Your son, Adil, is taking up more roles in your group. What are your three lines of wisdom to him and the other young leaders around?
Okay, the first thing is, it's my brother, I would say very frankly. He has been my wall, my support from the beginning. When I came to UAE, he was the one who joined me. He's still there with me, and we worked together. He handled my sanitary, hardware, and other businesses. My son, when he took over, when he graduated, he asked me, Daddy, what should I do? So I told him, you better join my business. So he says, no, I don't want to join my business. I join your business. I want to do something of my own. So at that particular time, we had started this company called Danube Home. It was called as Danube Pilmart. I said, you take this company, because I'm not able to manage this. It's too much of me to handle this two, three business at a time. So he says, but this is your business. I said, no, it's my business, but you're going to take it over. And I promise I'm not going to interfere. This will be your business. So he started managing that business. And my brother, who is handling my sanitary and hardware. So they all have different things to manage. And what is important, and what they have learned from me is, you know, they still work very hard. And they are very focused, very grounded. And they are both very smart. I would say more smarter than me, because if you look at, I have my still all my, when I do my work, it's all the old school thoughts which I work with. But they have come with different new ideas, different new innovation, which helps the company grow a little bit more longer than, more faster than which I would be growing. Of course, I have my ideas to do, but like I said, I would still think that of the old school thought. Like, I would not go into the more detail at this, how it's going to work and how the, but because of the technology they are able to use, or because of the education they are able to do much better.
So you will say to trust your son, and or to, in general, to a leader, a businessman, but as a son, you will suggest him, for example, to trust the son, to let him be free to do, to build by his own.
Absolutely, this is very, very important, because, you know, if you don't do that, he will never come out of the shell. Okay, yes, he will make some mistakes, and probably everybody will not be as smart as my son. He will have somebody who is more smarter, or he'll be somebody who is less smarter. But then, okay, yes, you need to groom him from the beginning. I mean, if you really do, I mean, the one thing which I forgot to mention was we taught Adil to learn about business when he was only 13 years old. When he was 13 years old, he was, while he was schooling, during the vacation, we used to send him to my different department, where he was going through HR department, logistic department, warehouse department, accounts, audit. So every year we used to send him to the different departments. So by the time he came out of the school or college, he already has a fairly good idea what is happening around in the company. Now that is very, very important, that as a parent, you should try and tell your children to start working at the age of 13 and 14 if you have the luxury of sending him into your company, send him to your company. If not, send him to other company or your friend's company or some other company where even if he has to work for free, but let him work for a few hours so that at least he gets into that route that yes, working is important for him when he goes up.
Experience to learn, you mean?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Danube is one of the most successful brands that has witnessed amazing growth in a short period of time. It has really addressed a big gap of affordable luxury in Dubai. My question is, will the expo delay benefit the real estate sector, sir?
It's not going to benefit, but it's not going to harm. Yes, because of the COVID, I told you, there will be some impact of the real estate center. So the sales may not be as much as what it was before the COVID. But Expo 2020 will help us to go more, will definitely help Dubai build up his reputation much stronger because a lot of people are expected to come to UAE and Dubai because of the Expo. So when the Expo comes in, it will definitely help us. But now because of the Expo delay, it's not going to help me more or delay or not help me more. It's going to work as the same way. It's just that I have to come out with more innovative product, more something creative so that the customers are interested in my product. And I have to reach out to the people who really want to invest. And I can see that as a huge opportunity in India where I feel that people will want to invest in Dubai.
How is the Danube functioning in other Gulf countries in current scenario?
Right now, as we are talking, the Qatar market is completely closed. They're still waiting for the lockdown to open. I'm sure they're going to open, that's what they say, by May 8th or May 10th. The same goes with Oman. Oman is also closed, so they will open by May 8th or 10th. Kuwait still hasn't announced when they're going to open. So Bahrain is partially open, so which I'm happy that they're open, like UAE. So UAE and Bahrain is open, but otherwise Qatar, Saudi, Kuwait and Oman are closed, which I am expecting it to open by the second week of May.
Do you believe that Indian buyers from India will be a bigger market opportunity and for your company and for other players, real estate developers in the United Arab Emirates post-COVID?
I'm 100% sure India is going to be my target market in the few coming months because I see a huge potential of Indian people coming and buying the properties. So I don't deny this fact that Indian people will come out and buy because there is a huge, the population of India is huge and everybody wants to, you know, with the problem which have arisen in the recent past, a lot of people want to shift their base or create some base into different countries. And there is no, Dubai is one of the best places where the flight is only 3 hours and we have almost 100 flights a day, every day going to India from Dubai to different locations of India. So there will be a huge potential of Indian people coming to buy from Dubai. There is no denial fact.
I have another question for you, Rizwan G. Experienced professionals are struggling due to the present crisis and to get suitable assignments. Will you go for giving opportunity and explore their experience and ideas connected with your business?
Of course, why not? But okay, if you ask me that if the idea requires a lot of investment, I don't have right now to invest a lot of money into a new venture because I would rather come back and controlling the business which I already have rather than exploring into new business in this particular way. But yes, definitely I would explore the ideas and if the idea is good, I will keep it for the future. But initially, if any investment is required, I would say no, I don't have any investment because I want to control and make sure business I have that goes properly.
Naturally. Can you come up for something like a rental guarantee? This will attract the investor more.
See, the best part, good you ask this question, you know, if you consider the rental which are happening in India or other parts of the world, when I say India or London, of a rental of only 1.5% to 2% rental that you get. Whereas in UAE, especially for the affordable segment which we are, I'm talking about 7 to 8% rental per year, which is huge money, you know, 7 to 8%. And this is not news. And I cannot come out with a guarantee, but anybody who sees my property will always feel, yes, Rizwan, the price which you're offering for the property and the quality which you're giving us the property, these prices can never go down. The rental, there will be always demand, like whatever projects we have launched so far in the past, you'll be surprised to note that I don't have a single apartment which is sold at a lesser rate, which means in spite of the market going down, people still want to hold on to my property because the property prices, the value of the property is so good. I mean, even in York, in India, there will, or any place in India like Mumbai or Delhi, there will be some few developers whose property will never come down because they have delivered a quality property. And the same applies to my quality. So that will not come down. Now, talking about the rental guarantee, I cannot guarantee because this is a market condition. It can go up, it can go down. But as of now, we're talking about 7 to 8% rental, which is very, very good. I mean, I can't think of, even if it goes down to 5% or 6%, it's still good. Nothing is wrong because I feel the appreciation of the property in the coming years will be very, very high. And the rental you are getting is also much higher than the other countries.
Rizwan, I thank you very, very much. I already stole 1 hour of your time.
Thank you so much.
I'm really sorry to have long it up so much, but it happened when you speak with very interesting people. I'm sorry for you. But I found you very interesting, and I believe also the public, because the question keep on pumping up. Even while I'm trying to say goodbye to you, I read the last question and then I'm going to let you go back to your business.
Thank you, Paula. Thank you so much.
Will you hire new professional to enhance your business? Saul Ahmed is asking. I believe you already answered to this question, but yeah. If you want to say a few words to Saul, I'm sure he's going to be happy.
Yes, the question is, will I hire new
professionals?
Yes, of course, I will hire new professionals. Right now, while I'm talking to you, there are a couple of people waiting for interviews into a different field. So as soon as I finish this call, I'm going to do the interviews because there will be a requirement. If you are in the market, there will be a requirement for sure. And like I said, we need to do something out of the box. We need to do something creative to be in this difficult crisis. So if I find somebody who is a professional and who has some different ideas, he will be definitely taken into account.
So now a question from my side to conclude this beautiful interview. Are you thinking to invest also in Italy so I can buy a property in Italy finally? I promise you, everyone in Italy speaks with my same accent.
Yes, I know. But unfortunately, I love your country. I go there many times, but I haven't thought about investing in Italy or starting a real estate company over there. But I love to go and buy some branded stuff in Italy. So I would rather buy the brands and keep here in the world.
No, but you have also to build, so I can also have my 1-2-bedroom apartment in Italy.
But you should look at the video. It's really good, you know, that you pay for 1 bedroom and use it as 2 bedroom. That has really caught up because a lot of people don't have the budget for 2 bedroom and they want to buy this 1 bedroom and have a family of a husband and wife and 2 children or 1 children. They can pay for 1 bedroom and live like a 2 bedroom apartment.
Rizwan, you have to invest in Italy, and especially after you invest, you sell it back to me.
I will do that. I will do that. Okay, but right now, instead of I give you a better thing, you come and invest in Dubai. Trust me, your investment will not go wrong. You'll be very happy compared to your investment in Italy.
I am sure.
You're not talking of a big money. We are talking about less than $100,000, you know.
It's for this that I'm asking you to also do in Italy, so I can buy both.
Okay, we'll look in that idea also. Thank you so much.
I thank you very much, Rizwan.
Thank you, Paula. Pleasure talking to you.
And an honor. Thank you for your time.
Bye-bye.
I wish you a nice day from me and from Asia One. Thank you very much. Also to your family. Yes. Sir, namaskar.
Namaskar to you also. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.